Hello, and thank you for calling by again. I'd like to talk some more about Chinese bamboo and the Chinese spirit. The bamboo plant, Fargesia spathacea, is the staple food of the giant panda and a cultural icon in Chinese history. In sharp contrast to other plants, the bamboo only blossoms every 60 to 80 years and perishes soon after. It takes 1 to 3 decades for its seeds to grow. In the past 3 million years, bamboos have undergone more than 50,000 extensive blooms. Pandas survived by migrating, but this is no longer an option owing to the sharp decrease of bamboo forests. The last two bloomings of bamboo caused 250 giant pandas to starve to death. In ancient China, bamboo was a feature of various aspects of daily life. It was used for food, clothing, housing, and transportation. China's first books were crafted from bamboo strips tied together on string, and almost all ancient musical instruments were made of bamboo. Bamboo also had assigned roles within feudal ethics. Chinese ancients designated the plum, orchid, bamboo and chrysanthemum as the four gentlemen, and pine, bamboo and plum as the three friends in winter. Renowned Tang poet Bai Juyi, 772-846, summed up the merits of bamboo according to its characteristics. He said, "Its deep root denotes resoluteness. Its tall, straight stem represents honorability. Its hollow interior, modesty, and its clean and Spartan exterior exemplifies chastity." He thus concluded that bamboo lives up to the title gentleman. Besides being a symbol of virtue, bamboo was believed to be endowed with soul and emotion. The mottled bamboo is the bamboo of imperial concubines. These origins come from a story about Emperor Shun, who died of overwork during an inspection tour of the south. He was buried in what is now Hunan province, and as his wives mourned him by the Xiangjiang River, their tears fell on and stained the bamboo growing on the bank there. A Tang poet wrote, "The trace of tears on bamboo gives expression to bitter yearning." Another breed of bamboo, Mengzong, honors a dutiful son. Mengzong was a student during the Three Kingdoms period, 220-280. His father died when he was an infant, and his mother was later stricken with a serious illness that did not respond to conventional medicine of that time. The doctor suggested that soup should be made from bamboo shoots. It might help, but they're impossible to find in the winter. Desperation and grief reduced Meng to tears. His sincerity moved the heavens, and several bamboo shoots broke through the soil. After taking the soup to his mother, she recovered, and word of Meng's filial piety soon became known across the state. Filial piety is a cardinal principle of traditional Chinese morality. According to Confucius, it is the essence of all benevolence. In some dynasties, rule of piety was set as a state policy. The Chinese also believe that a dutiful, loving heart and an honest heart are incorruptible. Ancient Chinese literati held bamboo in profound esteem. This explains why there are so many writings and paintings dedicated to it all throughout the massive history of China. On moving to a new residence, Eastern Jin calligrapher Wang Huizi had bamboo planted in the courtyard before furnishing any of the rooms, saying, "How can I endure a day without this gentleman?" Song author Su Shi, 1037 1101, expressed his talent not only in his poems, but also in paintings of bamboo. A student of celebrated bamboo painter Wen Tong, Su held that the consummate portrait of bamboo is one derived from close observation of the plant and minute comprehension of the ethos it incarnates. He was quoted as saying, "I can live without meat, but not without bamboo." His remarks, "While painting bamboo, one should have a finished image of it in the mind." It gave rise to the concept of having a well-thought-out plan. Of all the painters in history, Zheng Bianqiao, 1693-1765, of the Qing Dynasty, is believed to have been the best at drawing bamboo. One of the Yangzhou Eight Eccentrics, Zheng was lauded both for his artistic accomplishment and moral character. Born into a poor but intellectual family, Zheng lost his mother at three and learned the art of painting from his father. He passed imperial examinations at county, provincial and national levels in his youth, but was not granted an official post until reaching the age of 49. While serving as magistrate of Huaizhan County in Shandong Province, Zheng decried corrupt officials and the cruel rich and showed deep concern for the masses. Such feeling can be discerned from his works during that period. For instance, one of his bamboo paintings bears the inscription, "Lying in my room in the office building, I hear the rustle of bamboo and wonder if it is the sobbing of the people. For us local officials, everything we do, no matter how trivial it might be, focuses on the people." Zheng's righteousness was resented by the influential and wealthy. During a severe famine, he decided personally to dispense the government's grain reserves to the starving people, and was subsequently removed from his charge. Rather than being angry, Zheng wrote the poem, "Orchids sequester in remote mountains and precipices. Bamboos sway to make cool shade. I should give up this official post as soon as possible, so that I can lie down among them with a light heart." Zheng later returned to his hometown of Yangzhou and made a living by selling his paintings. Zheng reveled in painting bamboo all his life. As a teenager, he put white paper on a lattice window and observed the shadows of bamboo. His paintings focused on the vitality of the plant, portraying it as spare and aloof, yet sturdy and proud. An inscription on one of his bamboo paintings reads, "Firmly cleaved to the mountain, take root in a fractured bluff, grow stronger after tribulations, and withstand gales from all directions." It was not only men that revered bamboo. Tang female poet Xu Tao, 618-907, remained single all her life, taking bamboo as a loyal companion. Her lines, "lush and hardy to show rare moral courage, hollow inside to maintain humility," are still quoted today. After Zhu's death, bamboo was planted in her garden to commemorate her. This area later evolved into the River Watching Tower Park in Chengdu, Sichuan Province. Today, as people become more aware of the interaction between mankind and nature, the establishment of bamboo reserves should bring growing areas of bamboo forest back to life. This will be of great benefit to the giant panda, and can also be viewed as a restoration of traditional Chinese values. Understand that when you see a painting that includes bamboo in a Chinese creation, know that when you see a Chinese painting that incorporates within it bamboo, it's not just bamboo. Thank you for listening.